Hey, what's up, guys? It's Darkroom Duels, and today I've made Mech Knight Invokes. Now, this deck is a really fun meta deck. Now, I really enjoy playing this around this deck. I've had it since Shadows and Valhalla kind of came out, and they released all the Invoke monsters and reprinted them all. I even got a hold of an Alistar, the Invoker of Madness. I absolutely love Invokes. I love the way that they play. I love the way that Makapa just controls the whole board and everything. It's just an awesome, awesome, awesome deck. So, without further ado, guys, let's get started on this. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Hit that bell, then, so become a part of Notification Squad, and we'll get straight on into this. I've actually had Mech Knights since they came out, but I didn't have the Invoke stuff, and so I just played Pure, and it was a lot of fun for a while, and then I decided, meh, I'll just invest in Shadows and Valhalla. You guys remember the box openings. If you guys haven't seen those, go look at my channel, and I have all the box openings where I opened like 3 boxes of Shadows and Valhalla. It was a lot of fun. So let's get straight on into this. So, I'm playing 3 copies of Purple Nightfall. Purple Nightfall's effect is basically that all the Mech Knights share the ability that if there are 2 or more cards in the same column as them, you can special summon them directly from your hand. So, like, if I have a set card and then my opponent has a monster in the extra monster zone, like in column 3 or column 4, I can special summon out a Nightfall into that position and make it 3 cards in the same column. All the Mech Knights have that ability. His effect is that you can target one Mech Knight monster you control and banish it until the next standby phase of my turn. And then if you do, you get to add a Mech Knight monster from your deck to your hand. So it lets you search just about any of your... It lets you search any Mech Knight you need directly out of your deck. So then I play 2 copies of Mech Knight Blue Sky. I really want to play this at 3. But I just don't. I played it 2. I see a lot of people play it 2, and I play tested it 2, and I feel like 2 is the better number. I kept trying to justify playing 3, and I just can't, because I can search it with Purple Nightfall, and it's like playing 5 copies of it anyways. But its effect is if it's normal or special summoned from your hand, you can add Mech Knight monsters with different names from your deck up to the number of cards that your opponent controls in the same column as him. So, like, if your opponent has, like, an extra monster, a monster under it, and then a spell or trap under it, you can add 3 Mech Knights directly from your deck to your hand, which is really cool. You're going to at least add, like, 2 to hand, maybe 1 if your opponent has a card. He always searches at least 1 card for me. I usually try and hold out and summon him when I can search, like, 2 or 3. But he's just a really good card. I played 2 copies of Indigo Eclipse, basically the shifty Mech Knight. If he's in the, if he's in his column, then you can, like, move him or move another Mech Knight monster to another column, which is pretty cool. And I really like that ability of being able to move him. For the final Mech Knight to play is 1 copy of Red Moon. Red Moon pops a card in the zone that he's in, and you can actually combo Indigo Eclipse and him together very easily by, you can do this really awesome thing. You can have Indigo Eclipse, like, you can have, Red Moon under a monster, pop it, use Indigo Eclipse to shift him to another position, and then pop another card your opponent controls. So it's really cool. Just by banishing a Mech Knight monster from your grave, you can do that. And you can get Mech Knights in the grave pretty easily. So then for the other monsters, I play 3 copies of Alistar, the Invoker. You need him at 3 because the deck just doesn't function without 3 to play Mech Knight Invokes. He's the star card of the deck, really. The Invokes, or the Mech Knights, kind of back him up to get your Invoked Makaba out on the field, and get so many cards on the field. They kind of like link, they kind of like go into one another, because Magical Meltdown, when it's activated, you get to add Alistar. When this card is normal summoned, you get to add Invocation, and then Invocation lets you get your fusion, and then you can banish Invocation or shuffle Invocation back in your deck to get a banished Alistar back, as well. So it's really like, it's really, they combo very, 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 very well. And it's just awesome. You get to add this card back to your hand if you shuffle an Alistar back into your deck. So just kind of like, the invocation engine just so rolls into one another. So for the hand traps, I'm going to play 2 copies of Ash, 2 copies of Veiler, and 2 copies of Ghost Ogre. You can play any kind of hand trap ratio you want here. I just kind of played around with this ratio. I played 6 in the deck. If you want to, you can drop a Ghost Ogre for a Winterbell, or not Winterbell, what's his name? Haunted Mansion, that one. You can play 1 of those, but I highly recommend playing 2 Veiler and 2 Ash at least, or you can play 3 Ash and 1 Ghost. Like, I mean, it's however you want to do it. I think 6 in Mech Knights is the perfect number of, you know, hand traps. So that's it for the monsters, guys. Let's get into the spells. So we play quite a few spells. Like, I mean, a lot of spells. So one Monster Reborn, just to kind of bring back what we need. One World Legacy Succession. It's kind of the same thing, except it special summons to a zone a Link monster points to. Book of Law. Basically, this lets us tag out. You tribute an Invoke monster, special summon a different Invoke monster with original attribute from that monster. So it tags your Invoked monsters out. So, like, you can summon, like, Makaba attack and then tag it out to summon, Kokaitis or whatever his name is. Summon that one. Or summon out, like, Purgatrio, that one. You can tag them out. Like, have this on board, swing, and then tag it out and summon this one, and then swing and OTK your opponent really, really, really easy. Then I play two Terraformings to add the Magical Meltdowns to hand. You need this at two to play it. Two Scapegoats just to add more monsters on board. Three copies of Mind Control. This card is amazing in this deck because you can just steal a card from your opponent. After you special summon a Meg Knight, you can steal it and then link them away to summon Alistair. Or summon your Morningstar, whichever way you want to go. Two copies of World Legacy Memories. World Legacy Memories effect is that it lets you special summon a Mech Knight from your hand or deck in defense position, but for the rest of the turn until the end phase, and you return it to the hand during the end phase, and for the rest of the turn after this card resolves, you cannot special summon monsters except for Mech Knights, which kind of sucks, but you set it, and then you activate it on your opponent's turn to get that additional ability to have another Mech Knight on board. And plus, it empties your deck a little bit. And a free 3K or free 2500 beat stick and Purple Nightfall is just amazing to have on board. Then I play three Call by the Graves because you want to stop your opponent's hand traps and stuff like that. Two Instant Fusions. Instant Fusion is good. I think it's a good two of in this deck because you can summon Thousand Eyes and put it in the extra monster zone, and it gives you another card in a column that isn't in a main monster zone to summon out a card, and then you can link it away after you steal something from your opponent and put like Linkaribo on board, and then have Linkaribo pointing down, special summon out a Mech Knight, banish Purple Nightfall, add something else to hand, and then you already have a Link Arrow pointing down just off of this one Instant Fusion. So, I mean, it's a really good card. I thought about bumping it to three, but I just played it at two. I want to see it sometimes. I play three copies of Invocation. I really, really want to summon out invoked monsters. So I play three invocations. And then I play three copies of Magical Meltdown. Magical Meltdown is a three of, is necessary because you really need it really fast. When it's activated, you can add an Alistair from your deck to your hand. And then the activation of this card, activated effects, including effects of fusion monsters, and a fusion monster cannot be negated. And also your opponent cannot, opponent's cards and effects cannot activate when a fusion monster is fusion summoned. So it's really good to protect your invoke monsters from being summoned, and it makes pretty much Speed Spell 3 or Speed Spell 4 Makaba being able to negate anything besides like Speed Spell 3 judgments and stuff like that. I mean, that's the only thing it can't stop, but they can't activate that in response to Makaba when this is on the field because it says they can't. So that's it for the main deck, guys. Let's get into the extra deck. The extra deck's pretty simple. It's basically invoked monsters all over the place. So we play one copy of Alistair, the Invoker of Madness. He's really good because when he counts as Alistair on the field, Alistair the Invoker while on the field, and while on the field or in the grave, if this card is fusion, if you fusion summon a card while you control this card, except during the damage step, you can discard a card, and if you do, add an invocation or Book of Law from your deck to your hand. So it lets you be able to tag him in and out, and plus he's an 1800 beat stick, and if he is on your field and you control, leaves the field because of his opponent's card effect, you can add an Omega Summon, which we don't play Omega Summon. One copy of Mech Knight Morningstar. If it's a Link Summon, you can discard a Mech Knight or a World Legacy card and add a World Legacy card from your deck to your hand. So it lets you add like World Legacy Memory or World Legacy Succession directly from your hand. And then also it has the ability that you can only use the effect of him once per turn. And then once per turn, if a Mech Knight monster battles an opponent's monster in a different column than it, it cannot be destroyed by battle. And also you take no battle damage from that. So like if I swing, they can't kill my monsters. And they can't like, if they swing at me like with like a Boral Sword, it doesn't die unless it's in the same column as him. So it's really good to stall your opponent out with Morningstar and the other ones. Boral Load because I need to be able to OTK, and Boral Sword because it's just really good. Unicorn to bounce my opponent's stuff, and Linkaribo for obvious reasons with Thousand Eyes and stuff like that. Link Spider I just play in here because I want to be able to use it with my tokens. I play my own little weird tech, which is one copy of Hope Harboring, and that's the reason I play two copies of the Shifty Mech Knight, is because you can special summon it and Purple Nightfall, and then overlay with them to make this on the off chance that you need it. So it's there if you need it, because they're both level 8. Two copies of Makaba, because it negates stuff all over the place. Purgatrio, because this is OTK Maker. You can also use Alistair to discard itself as a hand trap to make it go by 1,000. So you can make this get up to like 40. You can get it up to like 53, and it does piercing damage and it can attack all monster opponent controls. So this is the OTK Maker of the entire deck. This negates, this is the shield, this is the sword, pretty much, of how you do it. You play this with Book of Moon. It's a link. It's a instant fusion target. You don't summon it that often with invocation, but you can. You play this. You play one copy of the water invocation. I always want to say Cocytus. It reminds me of him from Overlord, but it's not. He cannot be destroyed by your opponent's card effects. So like, and he can't be targeted either. So you just put him in defense position, and they have to get over 3,000 to be able to destroy it. In Sky Striker matchups, cool thing, they can't Widow Anchor it. Even though Sky Strikers are becoming less and less of a thing, you put it in defense position and they cannot really beat over it. And it's hard for them to get over it. So you just kind of sit on it and you attack him over and over again, because he can attack while he's in defense position, and you apply 1800 and you just swing at them for 18 as many times as you need to. I play an Elysium. I think Elysium is really underrated. I think they need to more invoked players need to play it. It's really easy to summon, and it's a 4K body. And then once per turn during either player's turn, you can target one invoked monster you control or in your graveyard and banish it, and all monsters your opponent controls with the same attribute as it. So you get to either banish light, fire, dark with him. Light, fire, dark. The only thing I can't banish is Earth, which is because I don't play him. You can play him if you want to drop Hope Harboring. You can play the big like Earth one if you want to. Like, you can do this if you want to. It's up to you. And then 1,000 ice for the instant fusion. So this is an option if you want to drop this and play it, or drop Link Spider and play it. It's up to you. But this is the way I'm playing the deck for now. So anyways, guys, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Tell me what you think of this deck down in the comments down below. It's a really, really fun deck. It's pretty meta. I would totally carry this to a regionals. I would definitely carry it to a locals and play it. It's just really easy to play around with. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Hit that bell on there so you can become a part of the notification squad. And I'll see you guys in the next video. See you around, guys.